all world that we have, God has given us nature as our hospital. God has given us previous knowledge, ancestral knowledge, ancient knowledge, as a connecting cable between generations. In other words, our forefathers, they once also were exposed to epidemics. They once were exposed to diseases and sicknesses. The question you must ask yourself, how did they deal with these problems? We will have been stupid of the highest order if we think that the knowledge of the past is useless. We are going to have our knowledge in the future. The future is experiments. Even these vaccines that they're now bringing to us, the vaccine against coronavirus, the vaccine around this, we cannot tell the side effects of these vaccines until another generation that comes forward. Now that they've been able to harvest corona and they will walk around the whole world in the midst of panic, please punch me here, give me some corona also, then you can protect me from corona. We are going to give birth to children who have coronavirus. We are going to live with people who have coronavirus. We are going to get blood transfusion that is coronavirus. We are going to give birth to another generation that is fully occupied by this virus. The question is, have we done enough research to find out what will happen in the future? And I believe in the midst of all these modern methods of healing, humble and beautiful as they are, the best method of prevention is factory default. Go back to the original. Eat well, sleep well, natural ways of giving birth to children, natural medications. We're in the event that there is no other way, then we can resort to some of these methods. Things like flus and etc. can be cured. And then I mentioned something that offended some other people again. In the event that you find that coronavirus is now in your system, why must you panic? Look to the east for some solutions. Look to the west for some solutions. Look to the north for some solutions. Don't forget also to look to Africa for some solution. Because I hear that the bacteria cannot survive above 28, 25, 29, 30 degrees. So what do you lose? By collecting your eucalyptus leaves, gum tree leaves and guava leaves, and make a nice big dish of water, pour with stuff in there, take a big blanket and smoke the virus out of your system. We call that steaming. Some of you might have beautiful bathtubs. Put yourself in a bathtub, steam yourself. Some of you are rich enough, you got saunas. You got a room that you know, these sauna rooms where you can put your nice things there and sit around your sauna room and steam your body up. Why? Because you want to increase the temperature and smoke the fever out of your system. But how about a lady who is living right in the rural areas, who does not have the plenty things of life? Can we always be waiting and saying until they can afford? Then they cannot be Christian enough. People who are living in the rural areas, who cannot afford the goodies of life like we have, can we also allow them to practice indigenous methods of healing so that they can deal with their own problems? I think it is totally unfair that those that are educated, those that have gone to school, those that have proliferated in academic institutions should take the constipation of their knowledge and walk around those that are quote-unquote primitive and impose some of those knowledge systems to them. Because not everyone can afford life like you can afford. Not everyone has a medical aid like you have. Not everyone can even walk to the pharmaceutical company and buy what you have. There's also a way you must keep the door open. The door of learning, the door of sharing, the door of development. If we can look at the wild animals, we can look at the trees, we can look at the environments that are around us, these environments continue to thrive. There are birds that are breeding in the lakes where we are living here. I've never seen anyone walking up to them with a vaccination or anything. There is a life that they are running without contamination from human beings. If there is a problem on earth, it is a problem that is brought by human beings. Because we're now putting poisons into the natural habitats of these things. And now when people want to become indigenous and original, because you have been brought up as a Christian, first thing you say to them, Maponga has become a sangoma. Maponga has become a witch doctor. Maponga is encouraging people to do this. Ponga is this. I am no longer worried about you. If you can afford your life and you believe that the Western world can give you the support that you need to live a better life, please keep on doing that. But I challenge you, until you understand what I'm saying, the original is always better. The original is always better. So I want to challenge the African community, especially all of you who are professional. Let's go back to indigenous birth control systems. Let's go back to indigenous birth systems. Let's go back to indigenous laxatives. Let's go back to indigenous cures of curing our headaches, cures of how to dye our hair, indigenous cosmetic products, indigenous ways of fixing our women's hair, and etc. Indigenous ways of governance, indigenous ways of commerce, indigenous ways of farming, protecting our seeds so that we don't eat genetically modified foods that also have their own side effects. I cannot shout louder than that. When the world is looking for technological Western methodologies of curing the problems which they created, some who will survive in these catastrophes are those who are going to take my word seriously. Go back to factory thought. Go back to indigeneity. Study these things. Play this video again and again until this message sinks in your ears. In the olden days when we were young and someone had a problem of eyes, for example, a young boy will be found, hey, please go and pee. Yeah, yes, pee. Go and pee in this one's eyes. And then someone would pee in someone's eyes and the infection would go away. Or go to a woman who is breastfeeding and would squeeze milk into each other's eyes. And then the infection will go away. In some certain cases, we'll be herding cattle and we'll be putting some of this milk in our own eyes. And our sicknesses were sorted. My grandmother, when I grew up, every change of season, she would take aloe, put it in water, and the aloe would turn into white, you know, the indigenous aloe from Zim. Then we all drink that thing, natural laxative, and our bodies and immune. We're healthy. I never slept in a hospital until I became an old man because of accidents and other things. But as far as health is concerned, we cannot trust the system that brought these problems to give us the solutions. If you remember very well, our aunties used to use that Ambi in the olden days. Their cheeks were bent only in another generation. 30 years later, they wake up to discover that these Ambis have lots of mercuries and what in them. How do you undo your own auntie who is now bent and her skin is cooked? Some of our men and women are now busy with the issues of skin lighteners. Skin lighteners have mercury. Another generation will discover these skin lighteners are actually poisonous. Must we wait to get sick so that we can start to think? Or knowledge is for free. Look back where you're coming from. That is the concept of Sankofa. By looking back where we are coming from, we can see where we are going. It is critical, my people. It is critical, my people, that we think intelligently and we think level-headedly. Let us not be too much constipated with Eurocentric Christianity and all its restrictive methods, with all its restrictive doctrines. We, on our corner, we are the ones who have truth. Everyone else is a liar. The other corner is also saying, we are the ones with the spirit. Everyone else is being run by demons. The other one is also coming. We are on our corner. And we have all these small little silos of myopic, small-minded thinking that we lock each other into spaces. And when sometimes the solutions that we are looking for cannot be found in our side, be open-minded enough to know that some solutions are across the globe.